We are gathered together today in the presence of God and in the company of family and friends to join together this man, Daniel Robert Huckstep, and this woman, Leslie Marie Hardesty, in God's holy institution of marriage. We all should know, as Daniel and Leslie do, that marriage is not to be entered into lightly or unadvisedly, but reverently, not only with the joy and hope of Christians, but also in awe of God, whose will they seek to follow. There are two major components to a godly marriage. The first is commitment, a commitment of life. In a Christian marriage, there must first exist a total allegiance to Christ and His will. With this commitment sealed by God, these two can commit themselves to one another. God designed marriage, not man. And in the Garden of Eden, God saw that it was not good for man to be alone. For this reason, He created woman, for her to be a lifelong partner, complementing and corresponding to one another. Let me emphasize the importance of uniting these two people. Marriage is the foundation of home life and social order, and must remain so until the end of time. It was sanctioned and honored by our Lord Jesus Christ. Genesis 2:24 reads, "For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh." With that understanding, I ask, who gives this woman to be married to this man?
With her mother and I's blessing, she happily comes to David to join his wonderful chest.
Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for Daniel and for Leslie and just their love. First and foremost for you. Lord, anyone that knows them has no doubt that their greatest passion, their greatest joy comes from you. And that is so necessary, Lord, that they find their joy in you. And Lord, now we just ask that you would just bless this covenant that they make, that it would be a lifelong covenant, that they would just be in love with you, and be in love with each other. Lord, bless their marriage and bless this day. Thank you for joining us here as we celebrate with them. In your name we pray. Amen. The second component to a godly marriage is love. 1 Corinthians 13:4 through 7 lays out the blueprints for godly love. I want to ask you, Daniel, and you, Leslie, to insert your name in place of the word love, and let this be the foundation for your marriage. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered, and it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. With love comes respect and honor. Paul makes reference to this in Ephesians 5:21 through 25. The Message version reads, "Out of respect for Christ, be courteously reverent to one another. Wives, understand and support your husbands in ways that show your support for Christ. The husband provides leadership to his wife, the way Christ does to his church, not by domineering, but by cherishing. So just as the church submits to Christ as he exercises such leadership, wives should likewise submit to their husbands. Husbands, go all out in love for your wives, exactly as Christ did for the church, a love marked by giving, not getting." Having read this, Daniel, you must love and honor Leslie as Christ loves the church. And Leslie, you must love and respect Daniel as the church, the bride, does Christ.
I, Daniel, take you, Leslie.
As a gift from God.
As a gift from God.
To be my lifelong companion.
To be my lifelong companion.
Through tears and laughter.
Through tears and laughter.
Sickness and health.
Sickness and health.
Work and play.
Work and play.
I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Constantly and prayerfully.
Constantly and prayerfully.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Thank you.
I, Leslie, take you, Daniel.
I, Leslie, take you, Daniel.
As a gift from God.
As a gift from God.
To be my lifelong companion.
To be my lifelong companion.
Through tears and laughter.
Through tears and laughter.
Sickness and health.
Sickness and health.
Work and play.
Work and play.
I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Constantly and prayerfully.
Constantly and prayerfully.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
The ring is a material symbol that has been designed to illustrate spiritual truth. The ring is a circle that never ends, just as God's love for us is like a circle that never ends. Because of this, you two will exchange rings as a sign of your godly commitment to each other and of your love that will never end. Daniel, do you give this ring to Leslie as a sign of your Christian commitment to her in marriage? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
Leslie, do you give this ring to Daniel as a sign of your Christian commitment to him in marriage? If so, answer, I do. At this time, Mr. Roger Bailey comes to read a passage out of Romans 8.
What then shall we say in response to these things? If God is not for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his son, but gave him up for all, how will he not alone, along with him, graciously give all to all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies. Who then is the one who condemns? No one. Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God, and he is interceding with us. What then shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we will face death all day long. We are on the threshold as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present or future, neither powers, neither height nor depth, no, nothing in all creation can separate us from the love of God who is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
You know, Daniel and Leslie, this next song is a very worshipful song, but their wedding wouldn't be complete if it didn't have a David Crowder song. How He Loves.
I'm thing, so I won't. Great couple, a role model of what a dating relationship should look like. Ecclesiastes 4, 9 through 12 says, two are better than one because they have a good return for their work. If one falls down, his friend can help him up. But pity the man who falls and has no one to help him up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strings is not quickly broken. Let's pray. Lord, we just thank you that you have joined us here today. We thank you for this couple and their worship of you, first and foremost. Lord, that you would just bless their relationship, bless their family, their future children. Lord, that they would just have a life, that they can focus on your will for their lives. Lord, thank you for the answered prayers on jobs and opportunities, and Lord, the prayers that are still in your hands. We just thank you for blessing them today, and that you would just bless them each day from here on out. Lord, we thank you again for joining us. We thank you for their family and friends who have traveled many miles to be a part of this day. In your name we pray. Amen. And Leslie, since you have committed yourselves to a lifelong love before God and these witnesses, and since you have agreed to meet the needs of each other, as long as you both shall live, acting in the authority vested in me by God and his church, I now pronounce you husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no man separate. Daniel, may kiss your bride.